In the first wave, there was shortage of PPE kits. In second wave, there was shortage of oxygen. And in the third wave, there might be a shortage of doctors. And right now, we are witnessing the same thing. Just 2 days back, I came COVID positive and I'm in home isolation. I want to emphasize that the situation is extremely serious and grave because every third doctor is either COVID positive or is showing symptoms and is waiting for their report to come. In Safdarjung Hospital, as of 6 January, 165 doctors were already COVID positive, and this situation is not only restricted to one hospital or one state. This situation is common to all the hospitals across the nation. I came positive in the second wave also, and after 2 doses of vaccination, I came positive this time also. I want to emphasize that this situation, this disease is equally debilitating. I had almost a similar experience in the second wave with the Delta variant. It causes fever, which is excruciating body ache and myalgia, weakness and severe headache. The situation is almost comparable. The only thing that the requirement for oxygenation is less common because the affinity of this virus for the lungs is less common. Talking about myself, I have locked myself in a separate room in my home in this home isolation period. I am very much concerned about my family because I reside with my aged parents who have comorbidities also. People say that Omicron is a mild variant, but the amount of distress and trouble it can cause to a person who is aged and who has some comorbidities already is not studied properly yet. And even the rate of infection is more in children, and I have children at my home. So I am very much concerned as well as scared. And my caregiver, that is my mom, keeps the food and everything at the doorstep only, wearing a mask. And I take care of all the precautions. I have a separate set of utensils also. But the problem is that all the doctors do not have so much space at their home to keep them separate in a isolated room. Secondly, most of the doctors, they reside in their hostels or in some flat, sharing the room with some other doctor. So as of now, no accommodation facility has been provided by the administration, and there is lot more of problem because how they will seclude themselves, how they will take care of their food. We have been raising this concern and we have been continuously warning the authorities that we were apprehensive since almost 2 months. There is acute shortage and crisis for healthcare workers all across the nation. This situation will funnel down and it will affect the patients only. For example, I am posted currently in Doppler unit, and there were 4 resident doctors who were posted there, and right now only one is working because 3 of us have came positive. So ultimately, it is causing a great distress, not only physical and mental also, among the doctors, but it is ultimately affecting the patient care also. Already late by 9 months, and even now counseling will happen in multiple stages, and at least 1 month will be required for the resident doctors to join their respective hospitals. Still, we are hopeful and we are taking it as a breather that now finally the doctors are going to join the hospitals and they are going to strengthen the healthcare system for better patient care.